Of class 12. Today we are going to rediscuss the derivation for E is equal to BC and also the derivation for C is equal to 1 by under root mu 0 epsilon 0. Now here you see that we have considered a electromagnetic wave to be moving along x-axis, and we consider a loop namely PQRS, which is in the plane of y, x, and we consider the distances of OP is equal to x1, distance OQ is equal to x2, and we also consider a strip of thickness dx at a distance x from the origin. Then obviously if we find the integral E dot dl for this loop PQRS, you will see that the two terms, that means for the case where we consider the arm PQ and arm SR, the E dot dl will vanish because E is perpendicular to dl. As it is obvious, we have considered that electric field of electromagnetic wave is along positive y axis and magnetic field of electromagnetic wave is along positive z axis. So that way integral E dot dl integrated over the whole loop PQRS, we get equal to E dl is equal to EX2L minus EX1L, because here we have considered that EX1 is the electric field of electromagnetic wave at point P, and EX2 is the electric field of electromagnetic wave at point Q. And similarly, if we find the magnetic flux associated with this loop, we can very well see that the electric flux, say d phi b, is associated with the strap. Then we can have total magnetic flux associated with the whole loop PQRS must be equal to the integral from x1 to x2 of the value bx into ldx, where ldx is the area of the strap of thickness dx, and we have considered the value l is equal to PQ is equal to, sorry, PS is equal to QR is equal to L. We have considered these arms are having the value, the length L. And so the area of the strip will be L into DX, that is SP is L, RQ is L, and so that means area of the strip will be L into DX. Now once we got this, we have integral total flux associated with the loop PQRS is equal to integral within the limits x1 to x2 bx into ldx. And we all know that the electromagnetic wave is a progressive wave, so we express it in the form b0 sin omega t minus x by c, and then on integrating it, we get b0 l, these are constants, so we take them outside, and on integrating it we get minus cos omega within bracket t minus x by c, and whole divided by minus omega by c. Here this factor is coming out of the integration for the factor within the bracket omega t minus x by c, and since it is within the limits x1 to x2, therefore we can have this value equal to cos omega t minus x2 by c minus cos omega t minus x1 by c, and we take this factor minus omega by c outside, so it becomes b0 lc. B0 l was already there on the top numerator and divided by minus omega by c, so that becomes b0 l c by omega. And you also see that there are minus sign in the numerator and denominator, so both of them cancel each other. And when we differentiate this factor d phi b by dt, then when we differentiate d phi with respect to time dt, then we have on differentiation we get b0 l c by omega was already there, and from differentiation we get the factor which eliminates omega, because omega will come out differentiating cos omega t minus x by c, we get a factor omega. So apart from the sine omega t minus x by c, so that way we got the value of d phi b by dt is equal to minus b0 lc within bracket sin omega within a small bracket t minus x2 by c minus sin omega within bracket t minus x1 by c. Now this is the expression for d phi b by dt, and we have already derived that e dot dl is equal to e0 is equal to E0 sin omega within bracket T minus X2 by C into L minus E0 sin omega within bracket T minus X1 by C into L. So E0 and L are common to both these factors. So on equating these two value means, when we put the value of E dot dl integral over the PQ, over the whole loop PQRS, equal to the total rate of change in magnetic flux for the loop PQRS, then we get on putting the value on solving, we get E0 is equal to B0 C. This is how we have proved this relation E0 is equal to BC. And now we also similarly, we can prove the relation C is equal to 1 by under root mu 0 epsilon naught. For that, let us consider a new loop PQRS which is in the plane of XZ for an electromagnetic wave which is moving along the positive X axis. And we again consider a strip which is having thickness dx, and the length of length of ps and qr equal to small l is taken. Then from the figure we can very much understand that integral of b dot dl over the whole loop pqrsp, we have the value b into x1 bx1 minus bx2 within bracket multiplied by l, where bx1 is the magnetic field of electromagnetic wave at the distance x1 which is equal to op, and bx2 is the magnetic field at the point q which is where oq is the distance x2 of q from point O. Here we have again considered the fact that magnetic field is perpendicular for the arm PQ and SR, therefore B dot dl becomes zero for these arms. Now so finally we got this relation on putting the value of B equal to b0 sin omega within bracket t minus x1 by c for bx1, and b0 sin omega within bracket t minus x2 by c for bx2. Now this is the value of integral b dot dl over integrated over the whole loop pqrsp. And again, if we consider the electric flux passing through this a small strip, we have we know the formula E phi E is equal to E into E dot A, and that means if EX is the electric field at that point where we have considered the strip DX of thickness DX, then we have total flux associated with the whole loop PQRSP will be equal to the integral PQRS of the factor EX into L DX, where L is the length of the arm PS and DX is the width of the strip considered. Now we integrate it within the limits X is equal to X1 to X2. The value of EX is given equal to E0 sin omega within bracket T minus X by C multiplied by L DX. Here you see that E0 and L are constant, and when we integrate sin omega T minus X by C, we get minus cos omega within bracket T minus X by C whole divided by minus omega by C within the limits X is equal to X1 to X2. So on putting this value, we get d phi E by dt is equal to differentiation of this term, and that becomes equal to E0 LC sin omega within bracket T minus X1 by C bracket close minus sin omega T minus X2 by C, and where we can very much understand how this happens, because D cos omega T minus X by C differentiated with respect to time, we get minus omega sin omega within bracket T minus X by C. So that way we got the value of d phi E by dt, and we also got the value of integral of B dot dl integrated over the whole loop PQRSP. Now we if we consider this loop here, there is no conduction current flowing through this loop in threading this loop. Therefore the Maxwell Ampere circuit law becomes integral B dot dl is equal to mu 0 epsilon 0 d phi E by dt, because we don't have conduction current flowing through this threading this loop. And on putting the value of B dot dl which we have just derived, B dot dl is equal to given by this relation 1, and putting the value of d phi E by dt in this expression, putting the value of b dot dl integrated over the whole loop is called, and putting the value of d phi E by dt in this expression, we get on solving c is equal to 1 by under root 1 by, c is equal to 1 by mu 0 epsilon 0. Here we have used a relation, substituted the value of E in terms of BC. So E0 is replaced by B0C, and then on solving we get C is equal to 1 by under root mu 0 epsilon 0. This is how we have proved that speed of light is constant for space, that is for vacuum. When we put the value of mu 0 and epsilon 0, we get the value of C is equal to 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second approximate value. Thank you and have a nice day.